It's a little bit afternoon, so good afternoon. May I have your attention, please? I don't have my court officers, so I can't do anything. Okay, I want to introduce a couple of folks right now so that we can get the speaking part of our program started. I'm going to ask Ms. Emily Shea, who's the Age Strong Commissioner, and Jose Masso Jr., who's Chief of Human Services, to come to the stage. Yes, ma'am. The microphone is yours.
All right. Thank you so much, Judge. Hi, everybody. Hello, hello. Happy Black Heritage Celebration. So important that we come together for events like this today. And I wanna give a big shout out to all of you, right? It's such an honor to be here celebrating with you today. I also wanna make sure that you saw our Age Strong Commission table, which is over here in this corner. So you're gonna be here for a little while after the dinner. So if you need to, if you want to know different resources that are available in the community or how to get connected to our office, we have a table over here. We also have our Mass Senior Action Council friends who are over there in the back, but they're walking around to the tables because there's a really exciting change for the Medicare savings programs. They're getting rid of the asset limit on those this year, thanks to lots of advocacy by a lot of you, right? Big round of applause for all of you who advocated for that. So we wanna make sure that folks know about that. So they're coming around to the tables with flyers for those as well. You know what I love about Boston? And I bet you love it too. I love that we all work together in Boston, right? Everything is a team effort. It takes us at the city, and it takes all of you in the community, and working together, we can make our community what it is. And so what I wanna do is I wanna introduce our Chief of Human Services. We are really proud to be a part of the Human Services Cabinet at the city. This is a place where we all can come together, where all the groups that kind of work front-facing with a lot of people in the city, and we can all work together to make Boston a good place with all of you. So please join me in a warm welcome for Chief Masso.
Good afternoon, everyone. I appreciate that. It is such a pleasure to be here with you all today in a beautiful, beautiful event. Such a great crowd and so many familiar faces. And for the folks I do not have the pleasure of knowing, I look forward to being able to meet you all. Again, my name is Jose Masso. I am the Chief of Human Services. Now, the Human Services Cabinet encompasses not only Age Strong, we also have Veteran Services, which had a beautiful event this past Saturday. There we go. Many of you were there as well. We have Boston Public Libraries. We have Boston Centers for Youth and Families. We have the Office of Returning Citizens. We have the Office of Youth Engagement and Advancement as well. Now, to be here with you all today, I believe it's the 10th anniversary of this type of celebration. And not only is it important in terms of celebrating Black History Month, the month, but celebrating today and every day. And somebody who we know, who's been a champion of that celebration, is somebody I have the pleasure of bringing up to the stage, and somebody who I have the pleasure of calling my boss, the Honorable Mayor Michelle Wu.
And I want to invite up all of the elected officials to come up as well, because you need to make sure to
know who they are and how they show up. I know I saw at least Representative Brandy Fluker Oakley, Representative Rob Consalvo, President, City Council President Ruth Louis-Jean. So come on up, electeds. And happy Black History Month and happy 10th annual Black Heritage Celebration with our Age Strong Commission. I want to thank the Grand Master and all of those who have made it possible for us to be here today. If you were part of the planning committee, could you give us a wave so we can give you some love? Thank you for continuing this incredible legacy. We know that Boston means so much, not only in each of our neighborhoods, but beyond across the Commonwealth, beyond throughout the rest of the country. It is Boston's progress that everyone looks to. And this year's national theme for Black History Month is around African Americans in the arts and in leadership in arts and culture. And there is no place in the country where that is more concentrated and still to this day more present than in Boston. We have some examples of that great legacy. We're going to see the performance from Black Nativity in a little bit. And so we wanted to join you all and honor and continue holding up the legacy that Boston has contributed from our Black leaders and community members over so many areas, but especially with this year's theme in the arts. That is one place that we have always shined bright, and it's thanks to you all who keep that going and passing that on generation after generation. I want to thank all of the city teams who are in the room. Of course, Commissioner Emily Shea and Chief Jose Masso and everyone at Age Strong. We have lots of volunteers in the house from our neighborhood services team. I know I saw Asha making sure food is still getting around to everyone as well. Commissioner Michael Cox is in the house. Thank you for all that you do, and thank you to all of our police officers. And although he's no longer working with the city officially, I feel like I am, you know, if I get the chance to work alongside Chief Masso, my boss is Brigadier General Enoch Woody Woodhouse, who's at every event that I go to. So, and just over the weekend received the first ever Legacy Award that was part of the Black Veterans celebration. So we have some proclamations that I want to give out in a little bit, but first I want to make sure that my colleagues in government say a quick hello, and I'm so honored to work alongside them. I'll kick it off with City Council President Ruth Louis-Jean.
Hello, everyone. Happy Black History Month. Mayor, I think we were joking about that. Colonel Woodhouse keeps a busier schedule than both you and I. He's everywhere. I'm so happy to be here. We know that a people without a history don't know the way forward. And so we know our history, we know that Black history is American history, and we know that February is not the only month that we acknowledge that. But it is our special month. We would not be here in the city of Boston without those who blaze the trail, like Ruth Batson, like Melania Cass, like so many who make stories like mine. My existence here, my presence on the Boston City Council, would not be possible without all of you fighting for us, praying for us, and paving the way. So I thank you all for all of the encouragement, all of the prayers. The way, same way you got us, we got you, in making sure that you can age with dignity. So happy Black History Month. I'm so honored to be here, and I'm looking forward to dancing with y'all on the dance floor. Thanks. Next up is State Representative Rob Consalvo.
Thank you, Council President. Good afternoon, everybody. I just wanted to be here today to wish you all a very happy Black History Month, but also to say thank you to all of you in this room. I see so many neighbors and friends and so many leaders, so many community leaders and so many people who have done so much for this city long before I ever got elected to the City Council or to the Massachusetts House of Representatives. We can't thank you enough, the trailblazers in this room who have made this city the great city that it is today. And so I just wanted to say happy Black History Month, and I look forward to seeing you, all of you in the neighborhoods again. And it's now my pleasure to introduce my colleague in the House of Representatives, State Representative Brandy Fluker Oakley.
Happy Black History Month, family. Yes, it's just a joy to be in the room and see all of, I know that they call it the Age Strong Commission, but in my mind, y'all are our personal national treasures. Like, seriously, yes, ma'am, because it's true. I know that Councilor President talked about the legacy y'all set before us, but there are so many unsung heroes, big and small, that made the city of Boston what it is today, and overwhelmingly Black folks like you, like my ancestors. My dad moved to Roxbury in the 40s from the Deep South, where his family hailed, and my mom came up from Alabama in the 70s. And when I think about the legacy of all that we have been through as a people, yet we still show up, we show out, we look darn good, okay? And I just thank God that we don't look like what we've been through. So thank you for being the leaders that you are in our city. We will cherish you today and every single day, and I hope you enjoy this celebration.
So I see the planning committee is keeping us on time track as well. We're running out of time. So I want to very quickly present the two official recognitions. On behalf of the city of Boston and all of our colleagues at the state level as well, I'd like to invite Rootsy and Brandy to join me in inviting up Dayama Battle and the Black Nativity team. And I believe Mr. Barry Gaither will come up on behalf of Black Nativity. So I won't read all of this. I know we're running short on time, but we just want to honor the contributions of Ms. Dayama Battle, founder of the art of Black dance and music, to unify people of African descent with work spanning four continents, and a recipient of the Boston Dance Alliance Lifetime Achievement Award, as well as Black Nativity, as you all know, a powerful retelling of the Nativity story infused with gospel music, dance, Black vernacular, and biblical narrative. It has shaped generations of leadership and connection to our city, and I've heard from so many young people in our city who are leaders today who participated in Black Nativity as young people over the years, and including the state rep. So this is truly two examples of the richness of legacy and leadership that we find in this community. Thank you so much. And I wanted to mention also that State Representative Worrell was here earlier and had to step out, but wanted to make sure that he was recognized. And then I want to give Councilor Julia Mejia, who just arrived, a chance to say hello as well.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's Councilor at Large Julia Mejia, just happy to be with you all celebrating Black History Month. It's all day, every day, 365 days a year. And while we only have 28 days to celebrate, we need to recognize 29. Oh, this month is 29, but you know the other times is 28, y'all. Let's keep it real. But listen, all day, every day is really understanding the important, rich history of Black Americans here in the city of Boston and beyond. So I'm just happy to be here with you all today. Thank you.
We'll invite up Ms. Battle and Mr. Gaither to say a few words.
I am so honored to be here with all of you. And I know many of you are up around my age level, and we keep on producing. Since I'm such a teacher and have been all my life, I wanted to share a few words with you from the Yoruba culture of Nigeria. The first word is ago. Let me hear you say that.
Ago.
Ago. That means, are you listening? Do I have your ear? Your response would be, ame.
Ame.
Ame means I'm listening. You have my full attention. Ago.
Ame.
Ago.
Ame.
Ago.
Ame.
So after the third one, it should be quiet. Hello.
I'm also very pleased to accept this proclamation for the National Center of Afro-American Artists, which is the linear descendant of the work of Dr. Elma Lewis. I know just from looking at this audience that there are many here touched by that work and whose children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren have been a piece of that extension. That is a living heritage that belongs to all of us. And I thank you for sustaining it and allowing it to grow and stay in place. And I want you always to think of it as your own piece of the living legacy.
I'm old enough and young enough to have still have mentors. And one of my professors just received a citation from the mayor. Barry Gaither was my instructor when I was in grad school. And I thank him. But I'm going to ask another one of my mentors, my former boss, to come to the stage and bring Black nativity to all of you. Come on up, Black nativity.
As director of the National Center of Afro-American Artists, it's my distinct pleasure to present an excerpt from our production of Langston Hughes's Black Nativity. It's important to remember that legacies live in works that breathe and grow. Langston Hughes, perhaps one of the most important artists of the 20th century, loved ordinary people, wrote novels, was an essayist, was a poet, was so associated with the imagination of the ordinary Black people that he became known as the poet laureate of the Black world. When he came to Boston in the late 1970s, he lit a fire in the heart of John Andrew Ross. And John Andrew Ross, who became the first director of music for the National Center of Afro-American Artists and the Elmer Lewis School of Fine Arts, produced the first season of Our Black Nativity in 1970 on Elm Hill Avenue. This year, we celebrated the 53rd season of Black Nativity at the Paramount in the theater district. Black Nativity, we present it as a gift from the black community, from all of us, to men and women of goodwill from all traditions. And in that spirit, it's an ambassadorial act to do. Let me do one other thing before sitting down, which is to say, every September, we do auditions for the show, because each year, approximately a third of the show is new. So all of you who love gospel and have a performance bug might think about whether you want to come in September and join us for an audition, and make sure that you plan that when December comes, you and your children and your grandchildren will be sustainers of this tradition. I present to you the Voices of Black Persuasion, the adult choral organization of Black Nativity.
Christ the Lord. while shepherds kept their watch. Oh, silent flock by night. Behold throughout the heavens, the song of holy night.
I want to take a moment to thank the cast, all those involved in Black Nativity, for such a wonderful presentation. If you have not been to Black Nativity, you've missed an important part of our culture here in Boston, and you must go see it. I also want to give a shout out to Steve Hunter, their wonderful pianist, for the work that he does, and how adaptable he is to whatever we need. Thank you, Steve. I'm going to ask, we can do dancing and music again. Yes, sir, thank you.